click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Chapter Nature of Chemical Bond, and we are doing the topic Formation of Boron Trifluoride using sp2 Hybridization. Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have talked about the formation of ethene using sp2 hybridization, and now in this concept we are going to study about how the formation of, that is, boron trifluoride takes place with the help of the hybridization concept. Let us talk about it. So now we are going to study about the formation of boron trifluoride with the help of the sp2 hybridization, but let us understand that the structure of boron trifluoride, and that could be BF3. So this is the molecular formula of BF3, that is what we are going to talk about. But if I observe this one, then boron is the one that will be present in the central most in the oral molecule, and that is what we have to concern with that, because hybridization it deals with basically electronic configuration also. So now let us understand that what would be the that is electronic configuration of boron and that of the fluorine atoms that are being involved. So talking about boron is the one which has an atomic number of 5. If you would say, then the electronic configuration can be written as basically 1s2, 2s2 and 2p1. So that's it that we have. But talking about the further thing, then we have to concern with that of the outermost shell, and in this case the outermost shell is basically this one, that is 2s as well as 2p. So these are the subshells that have been involved in the outermost shell. And if we are talking about the orbital form, so therefore the s has only one orbital, but the p subshell consists of basically 3 orbitals. That's it. And now let us fill the electrons over here. So as we could say that there are 2 electrons in the 2s subshell, while 1 electron in its p subshell. But the thing that we need is, we need basically 3 fluorine atoms so as to form, that is BF3 or boron trifluoride. But let us talk about this one only, that is I am mentioning over here, that is talking about fluorine. So fluorine has an electronic configuration that could be given as 1s2, 2s2 and 2p5. So again, if I talk about the outermost shell, so this is the outermost shell which consists of basically 1 orbital of s and 3 orbitals of, I would say, 4 p orbital, for p subshell. So it has basically 2 electrons that I am mentioning over here and 5 electrons in p orbitals. So that is what I could follow the Hund rule, and I could get this unpaired electron that is being present in the pz orbital of fluorine atom. So now basically as I could see, that is only one unpaired electron is present in the outermost shell or outermost orbit of boron. And meanwhile, talking about the fluorine also, it also consists of basically one that is unpaired electron, and that is what we could say, that there will be only one bond between boron and fluorine. But we are talking about, that is BF3. So obviously we have to make such kind of empty spaces or such kind of vacant orbitals so that the 3 fluorine atoms can easily accommodate in the orbitals of the boron. So that's the reason that the electronic configuration that I have made for the central boron atom in the molecule of BF3. So this is basically, it represents the ground state of it. So for which we have to actually shift the electrons, or we have to excite the electrons in such a manner that we should get at least 3 unpaired electrons or 3 vacant places where the fluorine atoms could accommodate their electrons, unpaired electrons. So that is what we are going to do, is we are exciting the electron of boron, that is the excited state that I am talking about. And in this case also, the orbital will remain the same, there will be no change in the orbitals, and this is what I am talking about. That is, what I will do is, while giving a particular energy, so this electron that has been present in the lower energy level, that is 2s, it will shift it to the higher energy level, that is 2p orbital. But the energy level is not that much, there is no that much of difference, but still because of which this electron can be shifted to this orbital, and this electron was present already here. So now in this case, basically we could say that s is been involved, px is been involved, and py is been involved. So these are the vacant or these are the half filled orbitals that we have got over here, and the rest of the thing is, it's very easy to understand. So I would say in this manner, that is during the bond formation or during the mixing of orbitals, basically one s and one px and one py orbital, they will be combining with each other, they will mix with each other, they will recast with each other so as to form new kind of orbitals or new kind of hybrid orbitals. And those hybrid orbitals can be written in this way, that is I am going to talk about. So now let us mix these orbitals and let us understand that what will be the hybridization of it. So we will get, basically we have included one s orbital as well as we have included two p orbitals. So in this case I would easily mention that there was one s orbital along with that of basically two p orbitals, that is px and py, and each of the orbital consisted of one electron. So therefore this is 1, 2 and this is 3 electrons that what we have got. So if you observe in this case, basically one s, one px and one py orbitals are being combining with each other. So therefore I could say that the hybridization that is it has been involved while mixing of the orbitals is basically sp2 hybridization. So this is how they will mix with each other and they will form a new kind of orbitals, and the shape of that would be, let me explain to you that how can we write the shape of that or hybrid orbital. So in this case basically one s is being involved, so this is the s orbital. While talking about one of the px has been involved and one of the py has been involved, so therefore I could say that the px orbital will have the shape of this one. While talking about the py orbital, it will have the shape of this one, like this. So now this three will mix up with each other and they will form a new kind of hybrid orbital with same same number of hybrid orbitals as I have included, that is one s, one px and one py, making three orbitals. I am mixing it, so therefore three new orbitals is what we could form, and that have a structure of basically. So this is the hybrid structure that I have mentioned over here. So even this is the one that is formed because of mixing of one s and two p. So therefore this all are the sp2 hybrid orbitals. But this is sp2 hybrid orbitals of the central atom, that is of one atom only, that is I am talking about like boron. By talking about fluorine, so fluorine, as we know that the electronic configuration can be written as 1s2, 2s2, 2p5, and in that case basically the pz orbital will consist of only one electron. So we could mention in that way, that is the pz orbital can be written as in this way, that is I am going to mention about. Suppose if I am talking about the pz orbital of the fluorine, so even that will have a particular shape, and this is what I am talking about. So this is representing the orbital of fluorine, basically, especially like pz orbital. So again, even this is the one which will be overlapping with that of the hybrid orbital of boron, that is sp2 hybrid orbital of boron. So fluorine, fluorines, that is pz orbital, it will be involved in that of the bonding with that of the boron. And here also it would be, basically I would write it over in this way. So now as you could see that the overlapping takes place of the fluorine atoms pz orbital over here. But here I have not included, that is electron. So suppose if the boron consists of, as we have observed over here, that is after mixing also, each sp2 hybrid, even this is sp2 hybrid orbital, sp2 hybrid orbital, and even this is sp2 hybrid orbital, and each of it consists of one electron. So this is what I am representing it, the electron of boron. So this is the electron of boron that I am representing it over here. And talking about the fluorine, fluorine also consists of the one electron in its outermost orbital, that is pz orbital, and that is what I am representing it with this electron. So here, as we have got to know, that is the overlapping is also the main thing that it takes place, and it overlaps coaxially. So making this to be, this bond to be called as basically, I would say it as sigma bond. Even this is the sigma bond and this is the sigma bond. So here the overlapping takes place between a hybrid orbital, especially I'm talking about like sp2 hybrid orbital with that of the pz orbital of the fluorine, and this hybrid orbital will have a greater extent of overlapping, making this bond to be called as the sigma bond. So that is how a complete stable structure is the one that is been formed. But meanwhile, talking about the bond angle, so that is the main thing that I am going to talk about, because this boron is the one which is exhibiting that is sp2 hybridization. So therefore it will have a bond angle of that of the carbon of the ethene, that was, it was showing 120 degree angle. So similarly here also the bond angle that I want to express in this case, it will be basically 120 degree. So every bond angle that we could observe over here, it will be 120 degree, and that's the reason that we could find the structure of BF3, it would be a triangular planar, and that is what I want to draw the structure over here. And that is, suppose if this is the boron that has been present over here, and this is the fluorine atoms, and they are evenly distributed in such a manner that the bond angle is basically, I would write it over here as 120 degree. But meanwhile, if I talk about the geometry, so this geometry actually, it includes, as you could see, it is a triangle that we could see. So the geometry is, triagonal planar with a bond angle of 120 degree. So this is all what we have discussed about it with the help of the hybridization, that we have did a concept, and that was very important for us to understand that what would be the structure of BF3. So this is what we have got because of the hybridization concept, and that's it. Thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly and you have got to know various concepts behind this one, and I hope you have liked this video. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you'll share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you.